Hello everyone, welcome to the class of Sachin Sir Physics, the finest and the easiest way to learn the concept. So I'm back with a new video, and in this video we're going to talk about the new point from the chapter Ray Optics and Optical Instrument. In this class we will derive a very important relation of refractive index with the object distance u as well as the image distance. So this is the main point of this class, that is refraction at a spherical surface, and also we will focus on very good example based in this topic. So please don't forget to watch this video till the end. So be ready to fall in love with physics. Before we all fall in love with physics, let's recall the previous lectures of this channel. In the previous lecture we were discussing about total internal reflection. Also we have covered the portion of reflection, the mirror equation, magnification and all the derivations. So anyone of you want to learn those previous concepts, tap your screen anywhere, you'll see there is a suggestion videos including the previous class videos. You can go through that, you can enjoy, you can learn all that videos. Okay, so let's derive the formula of that refractive index relation with object distance as well as image distance. So you can see we have a glass slab, a kind of transparent medium, and from this point at a distance u we have an object. So basically O is the object and this u is said to be the object distance. Now we have to find the image of this object, then at least two rays will pass through it. One ray is traveling in this way, striking at this point, particular point. Suppose that point is point P, alright? So at the particular P point, this ray is incidenting on it. And this is the point C, and the meaning of C is center of curvature. When you draw a line from C, it is said to be the perpendicular line, or you can say the normal line, because it is a kind of a spherical surface. So whenever you draw a line from the center point to its curved surface, it always makes an angle of 90 degrees. That's why it is said to be the normal line. Okay, so this ray is making an angle I, or else you can say theta 1, with this normal line. And we know the rules of this type of refraction. Whenever, which I have already explained in my previous videos of refraction, whenever rays travels from rare medium to dense medium, whenever rays travels from this kind of rare medium to the denser medium, then it always bends towards the normal line. It should move in that way, but it always bends towards this normal line. This one is called your normal line. It is not moving like that, but it is bending away from this, moving towards this normal line. And always you have to take your angle with the normal line. Here the incident angle is I, and this angle is said to be your refracted angle. Okay, so after being refracted from that point, it moved away and it is meeting at this point. Another rays which is passing through point O is directly going towards the point I. So it is not going to refract because it is directly passing through the center. You can say it is directly passing through the pole, or it is directly passing through the optical center. So कोई भी rays अगर directly चल रही है तो बिना refractive, अगर straight चलती है तो previous video में भी मैंने explain किया था, straight चल रहा है, जीरो रिफ्रैक्शन होगा, और अगर जीरो रिफ्रैक्शन है तो बिना रिफ्रैक्ट हुए वो सीधी आगे चली जाएगी, और जो दोनों इंसिडेंट रेज यहाँ पर रिफ्रैक्ट होके जिस पॉइंट पर मिलेंगे, दैट पॉइंट इज सेट टू बी द इमेज ऑफ दिस ऑब्जेक्ट. हेंस फ्रॉम दिस पर्टिकुलर पॉइंट टू दिस पॉइंट यू कैन टेक वी. नाउ व्हाट इज वी? सो वी इज योर इमेज डिस्टेंस. And we also know that from this particular center to C, it is your capital R, and this is your radius of curvature, which is a type of radius. C is the center, hence this is said to be your radius of curvature. तो देखिए basically होता क्या है कि हम जो पहले refraction study किए थे वो refraction एक plane surface पे था, right? इस तरह का plane surface था. बट अभी क्या है, ये प्लेन सरफेस नहीं है, इट इज़ अ टाइप ऑफ कर्व सरफेस. सो द कंडीशन विल बी डिफरेंट एंड वी हैव टू डिराइव दैट कंडीशन. कैन यू इमेजिन? यू शुड. ओके, Initially, it was a plane surface, but right now it is not a plane surface, it is curved surface. So we have to imagine, all right? Then capital R is the radius of curvature. Okay, suppose this particular angle is alpha and this particular angle is beta and this particular angle is gamma. See, in your NCRT, one thing I should clear, in your NCRT, this derivation is given with different way on page number 323. We will derive this equation with our easiest way. And I tell you, if you are doing these kind of derivation, nobody can cancel your marks. You will get full out of full marks. Okay? Without any hesitation, you can write this derivation. Because after uploading this video, I know ki bahut sare comment aate hain ki sir, main is board se hoon, main yahan se hoon, main ye kar raha hoon, so can we use your derivation? 100% you can use this derivation. Because at the end, if your point is perfect and if you are getting the same answer by the different method, doesn't matter. Matter ye karta hai ki aapko wo acche se samajh mein aa gaya ki nahi, theek hai? To hum yahan pe different angle le lete hain, alpha, beta and then gamma. Now observe a triangle OP and then that is C. In this triangle of OPC, we know that I is your exterior angle. Jaise ye triangle hai, yahan pe line draw kiya, to ye exterior angle ho gaya. If this is Y, this is Z, to 100% X is equal to Y plus Z. It is a theorem. Your exterior angle is always equal to the sum of interior angle. So in this triangle mein interior kaun hai? Your alpha as well as beta. So that I can write I is equal to alpha plus beta, equation number 1. In the same way we have another triangle, that is PC and I. Kajab kya naam hai yaar? PCI. Sasha. Okay. Kuch bhi. So in triangle humne ye bola kyu? Theek hai. Triangle PCI, which angle is your exterior angle? Come on, observe kariye, P, C and I, 100% beta. Can you imagine? Yes, you should. So beta is equal to R plus gamma. Make R subject, so R is equal to beta minus gamma. It is your equation number 2. After getting this value of incident angle, as well as refracted angle, now we will use a very famous equation for refraction, which is Snell's law. Kabhi bhi refraction aata hai, whenever there is a kind of refraction, you can use that Snell's law. And what is it? It is neta 1 sin theta 1 is equal to neta 2 sin theta 2. That neta word is a kind of refractive index. बहुत सारे रेफरेंस बुक में ये म्यू के यू के फॉर्म में रहता है. म्यू आप बोल सकते हो, उसको डिपेंड करता है बुक्स पे, डिपेंड करता है आप कौन सी रेफरेंस बुक यूज करते हो. बट मेन थिंग इज यू शुड अवेयर ऑफ दैट कि दिस पर्टिकुलर नोटिफिकेशन इज फॉर रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स. ओके, सो आई विल यूज नोटिफिकेशन एज नीटा फॉर द रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स बाय यूजिंग द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ स्नेल्स लॉ एट पॉइंट P here, at this particular point P, N1, that is the refractive index of this medium, then sine I, this is your incident angle. Achha, haan, you should take a proper care while you are applying this application, this law, then always take your incident angle and refracted angle from this normal line. दूसरा वाला नहीं ले लेना, अदरवाइज रॉन्ग हो जाए. ये नॉर्मल लाइन से इंसिडेंट ने कितना एंगल वा बनाया है और रिफ्रैक्शन वा ने कितना एंगल बनाया है, यू हैव टू राइट दैट. ओके, सो N1 साइन I इज इक्वल टू N2 एंड देन साइन R. ओके, फॉर द स्मॉल एंगल व्हिच आई हैव ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन सो मेनी टाइम्स फॉर पर्टिकुलर रे ऑप्टिक्स एज वेल एज वे ऑप्टिक्स, इफ यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट साइन थीटा यू कैन टेक थीटा. If you're talking about tan theta is equal to theta, small angle ke liye hum le sakte hain. So for small angle, because ye ray optics hai, uspe jitne bhi angle honge, aapko sab imagine karna hota hai. Isiliye we can take sin I is exactly equals to I, and then that sin R is exactly equals to R. Okay, so I have to check my camera. Q कि ये कहाँ तक बोर्ड पे कवर कर रहा है, धन्यवाद, इतने में हमारा काम हो जाएगा। सो साइन आई इज इक्वल टू साइन आर। ओके, द नेक्स्ट स्टेप विल बी इन दिस इक्वेशन आई कैन राइट एन वन साइन, सॉरी साइन आई इज आई, सो एन वन आई इज इक्वल टू एन टू, दैट इज नीटा टू एंड देन आर। By using equation 1 and equation 2, I can put this value over there. I की value है alpha plus beta. So n1, that is alpha plus beta, is equal to n2. Then I have that refracted angle from this equation, that is beta minus gamma. So it is n1 alpha plus n1 beta is equal to n2 beta minus n2 gamma. Okay, so we will shift this beta over there, minus will be shifted over left side, n1 alpha, this minus, that is plus n2 gamma is equal to n2 minus n1 and then beta. ठीक है, n1 alpha plus n2 gamma is equal to n2 minus n1 into beta. Alright, bacha party. So after this particular line, n1 alpha plus n2 gamma is equal to n2 minus n1 beta, we can remove alpha, gamma and beta by 10 alpha, 10 beta and 10 gamma. But to get these values in diagram, you should take this perpendicular line, and if you are drawing a perpendicular line from point P, you will get PQ. But this distance is, you know, that is very very small comparison to that U, that R as well as V. So you can neglect that. That particular distance you can neglect. So if you are talking about the distance from point O to Q, you can take U. Q to C, you can take R. And then Q to I, you can take V. Okay, that is a small distance, so we can neglect that. So after this particular line, if I write tan alpha, then tan alpha will be front upon side, you can say the perpendicular upon base, so PQ upon U. But you should remember that if you are writing tan alpha is equal to PQ upon U, then there will be minus. Why minus? Because of the sign convention rule, on the left side we have to take minus distance. And then tan beta for this particular triangle, if you take tan beta, that is perpendicular PQ, and that side I have already explained, you can ignore that distance, that is R, a very small distance, so upon R. Why I am taking plus? Because it is on the right side and all the right side distance will be positive. Okay, the third one is for that triangle PQI. If you take gamma, then in front of gamma we have PQ, and that particular side will be V. So here we have three different values of tan tangent, tan alpha, tan beta and tan gamma, and we know that for a small angle we can take tan alpha exactly equals to alpha. So for this tan alpha, I can consider it as alpha, I can consider that beta, and I can consider this as gamma. So what I'm doing is n1 as it is in that particular equation, n1 as it is, then put the value of alpha from this, that is PQ by minus U, n2 as it is, and in that we have gamma, and we have the value of gamma, that is PQ by V, and n2 minus n1, n2 minus n1, beta, that particular beta is what, PQ by R. So at last, if you take PQ as a common, you'll get minus N1 upon U plus N2 upon V is equal to N2 minus N1 upon R. And I tell you, it is very important equation for all the kind of competition wala exam as well as your NCRT or you related to any board. But there is one wonderful concept behind this equation. You can use this equation only when your rays is traveling from rare medium to the denser medium. When your object is kept in rare medium, please concentrate on this sentence. When your object is kept in rare medium, only when, that's it. अगर आपका ऑब्जेक्ट रेयर मीडियम में है और उसकी जो रेज है वो डेंस मीडियम में जा रही है तो आप ये इक्वेशन यूज़ करो. बट इफ़ योर ऑब्जेक्ट इस्केप्ड इन डेंस मीडियम, थोड़ा सा चेंज करना है, इस एन वन की जगह पे लेना है माइनस एन टू अपॉन वी सॉरी यू प्लस एन वन अपॉन वी इज इक्वल टू एन वन माइनस एन टू बाई आर. प्लीज़ 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 नोट डाउन, ऑब्जेक्ट अगर डेंस में है तो ये इक्वेशन, एंड इफ़ योर ऑब्जेक्ट इन रेयर मीडियम थारे को ए यूज़ करना है. भाई सीधी भाषा में कह रहा हूँ, से कोई टेंशन वाली बात है को नहीं है, टेंशन वाली बात देख के थारे को लगता नहीं है कि मैंने जो बोला है समझ में आया है, नहीं समझ में आएगा थारे पास कमेंट है, कमेंट करना भाई, कमेंट में पूछ लेना हमारे से. और तो भी ना समझ में आए ना सीधी भाषा में क्यों, इंस्टाग्राम तो यूज़ करे है आजकल तो लोग बहुत यूज़ करे हैं, आपके सिद्ध हमारे से वहाँ गोली बंदूक सामने रख के पूछ लेना. ओके ठीक है, हाँ तो ये हो गया, फटाफट इसका स्क्रीनशॉट लो यार, उसके बाद हम लोग करेंगे क्या करेंगे, हाँ एनसीईआरटी का एग्जांपल, बहुत रात हो गई है. ओके जब देखो भाई थारे वास्ते न्यूमेरिकल है, टेक्स्ट बुक तो थारे पास हो गई, वो टेक्स्ट बुक में से थारे को क्वेश्चन देख लेना है, उसके बाद इधर आके सॉल्यूशन देखना है. सो इन दिस एग्जाम्पल वी हैव टू फाइंड द पोजिशन ऑफ इमेज. So how we will get that position of image? We have a simple equation that is when you read this question you will come to know कि भाई हमारा जो object है वो rare medium में है, and if that object is rare medium so you can use this equation by minus n1 upon u plus n2 upon v is equal to n2 minus n1 upon what r. So n1 is what? It is actually the refractive index of the rare medium. अगर rare medium में कुछ नहीं है तो हवा मान सकते हो, और हवा का तो हमेशा refractive index is always 1. So minus 1 upon u, that is object distance. Look, your object distance is 100. ऐसे ही लिखा होता है 100, but वो आपको मामा बना रहा है. आप सही से करो ना, object distance इधर है, इधर you should take it negative, left side है तो minus 100, then plus. What about N2? N2 is the refractive index of that transparent medium or the glass slab that is given 1.5. So 1.5. V is your task. Now what about N2? 1.5 minus N1, that is 1. What about radius of curvature? Mm-hmm. That is given 20 centimeter. देखिए तो सही 20 centimeter. इतनी सारी variety की आवाज़ें क्यों आ रही है मुझे? हाँ ठीक है. So that capital R is 20. Will it be positive or negative? अरे यार right side है तो positive ही होगा. ये ढेंटेंट करके पॉजिटिव 20 हो गया. ये देखो माइनस से माइनस कैंसिल हुआ यार, ये बहुत इजी है. 1 अपॉन 100 प्लस 1.5 अपॉन वी इज इक्वल टू 1.5. मेरा मैथ्स बड़ा वीक है. हाँ हाँ 1.5 माइनस 1 0.5 सही है. हाँ जी अपॉन 20. और जी अब इसके बाद मैंने सॉल्व नहीं करना. 0.5 अपॉन 20 माइनस 1 अपॉन 100. और जी तुसी सॉल्व कर दो और इसका आंसर देख लो, ये पॉजिटिव आएगा जी. पॉजिटिव आना ही बनता है क्योंकि अगर पॉजिटिव होगा तो ही तो राइट साइड आएगा, राइट साइड है तो पॉजिटिव है. ओके तो वी विल एंड द वीडियो नाउ. सो आई होप यू एन्जॉयड दिस डेरिवेशन, एंड इफ़ यू आर रियली एन्जॉइंग दिस वीडियो देन प्लीज़ डोंट फॉरगेट टू सब्सक्राइब दिस चैनल एज वेल एज शेयर दिस चैनल इन योर ऑल ग्रुप, because this channel will help those students who are not going any tuition classes. ठीक है तो हम सभी की help करना चाहते हैं और हमारा भी help आप लोग कर दीजिए channel को subscribe करके, like करके और share करके. ठीक है उम्मीद करूँगा कि आप लोग ये ज़रूर करेंगे. so thank you so much for watching all this video from this channel, and जल्दी मिलते हैं next video में. next video is about refraction by the lens which is given on page number 325. तो खुश रहिए, हमेशा मुस्कुराते रहिए, आपके आसपास के लोगों को भी खुश रखिए, और फिजिक्स ऐसे ही मुस्कुराते हुए पढ़ते रहिए. जल्दी मिलते हैं नेक्स्ट वीडियो में. टिल देन डू व्हाटएवर यू वांट टू डू मैन, बट डोंट ट्रबल योर मॉम.